So today I'm going to talk a bit, little about the readjustments of our own expectations. Now, why do I talk about the readjustments to our own expectations is because one of the reasons why people come to temple is because they are very troubled outside, and so they want to come to the temple to find peace and solace, right? Correct? Even though fundamentally it is not wrong, okay, but ultimately there is something wrong with that. You want to know why? It's because, okay, now I put it the other way around, huh? Do you not find that there will always be people who will come temple, come listen, come forward, after that they get fed up and don't come back anymore? Does that happen? Yeah. And that even happens to you, isn't it? Huh? That even happens to you, isn't it? And that will have, and that becomes to become a kind of, then people say they get lung. Mental frustration, fed up, anger, and complain, and this and that. So something, there's something wrong. Somehow, somewhere, there's something wrong. And then, therefore, they say that, oh, what's the point of going to the temple? I can practice at home. Today, I'm going to address this issue point blank. Okay? It's up to you whether you want to face yourself. After listening to this, if you don't like to hear what I just said, you don't want to see me anymore, I accept that. But from day one on, that what my guru asked me to do, I've done. And I have not kowtowed myself to anybody just because they are rich. Okay? Good or success of me of that is because of that. Failure of me is also because of that. Some people say that I don't kowtow to the rich, so therefore I have to work very hard. Some people praise me that because I don't kowtow to the rich, that's why there's some success. Truth is, I don't give a damn. Truth is, I don't give a damn. Why should my success be measured by what your mouth say? Correct? Similarly, why should the happiness of your life be influenced by what other people's mouth say? Isn't it? That's why the 8 verses, the 8 worldly dharma, you know, being happy when praised and being upset when somebody says something bad about you. Now let's go to the earlier thought that says that when people want to come to temple in search for peace and solace, for peace, look for that something, but somehow they get it worse when they see that Rinpoche, especially the one that's talking now. Many other Rinpoches are always smiling, very nice. Oh yeah, oh yes, this, that. Too bad I happen to be not one of them like that. I just be natural, better. I'm not somebody who all the time scold you, right? Right? In fact, I don't feel you see me scolding people very much. But when I want to, how to say, 对付你叫什么? Huh? Huh? English teachers? Huh? If I want to deal with you, yes. If I want to deal with you, I don't have to scold you. I don't have to beat you. But you will feel worse than being scolded or beaten. Okay? How do I manage to do that? It's not because I have some superpowers. I don't. It's not that I am Buddha. I'm not. It's not that I'm somebody special. I'm not. If I'm truly somebody special, then stably will always be special, you know. But then it becomes, when people like you, you are special. People don't like you, you are like what is in the toilet bowl. So how can anybody be special? Not you, not me. Right? So when people only want to come to temple in search for solace, in search for peace, if in search of happiness, that means these people have desire. That means these people have an idea of what they want, which is most probably a corrupted idea. Right? Hello? Yeah. Is your love, your peace, your happiness same as the people sitting opposite there? Huh? Yeah. Same as the next person next to you? Okay. So if you have an idea of what you want and you go to a temple to search for particular things to get what you want, you're going to suffer. That is why end up you'll be deluded. You'll be sad. You'll be unhappy. You'll always be searching. Search here, search there, search everywhere. But not find somebody that will dare to present yourself in your face. That's what I said before. If you meet yourself in the street, will you like you? Correct, no? You know, people, just one look at the face, they already generally have a particular idea whether I like your face or I don't like your face. Or I like you or I don't like you just by the presentation of your hairstyle and your face. Correct? Hair color matter? Does hair color matter? Hairstyle matter? Okay. Ladies, somehow they have long, wavy, curly hair. It's pretty and beautiful. If I let down my hair, I also got long, wavy, curly hair. First thing people say, hey, you look like ghost lah. You didn't tie your hair up and you look scary. But it's the same, it's just long, wavy, curly hair. Why long, wavy, curly hair looks good on some people, don't look good on all people? Okay? So, fundamentally, everybody wants to have happiness, so go to the temple or place of worship where everybody throws their desire to Buddha. And then Buddha say, I'm here to tell you that your desire brings suffering. Right? Buddha thought, all desires bring suffering. All wants, all needs bring about your own suffering. Nobody give you your suffering. Nobody give you your idea of how things should or should not be. You had it yourself. For example, if somebody who is trained as an accountant, everything must go by the book. Everything must go by this and that. You know, follow step one, step two, step three, step four. Then, you ask this person to do service business. Can this person do well? Can this person do well? He can, provided he is willing to change. What I really want to tell you about today is doing the same damn thing over and over and over again and expecting a different result is totally ridiculous. You look at what you are doing day in, day out. Do you feel you're going to get more happiness? Hello? You do the same thing day in, day out, you're going to get more happiness, more money, more love. Hello? Huh? Main thing is, if you don't want to change, you're screwed. If you don't want to change, if you just keep on telling yourself, I don't know how to start. I don't know how much to do. I'm at a crossroad of my life. Who is not at the crossroad of their life? Every day, everybody, every morning, they're at the crossroad of their life. You want to die or not, also the crossroad of your life, isn't it? If you suddenly wake up and snap, okay, let's go jump off the building today. Woohoo! Yeah? Jump off at which story? Right. I also jump off the building. I walk to the last final step and just jump one step down. I jump off the building. Right? So the main thing is this. You and I have to make conscious choices every day. The conscious choices that we make every day are based on how made them yesterday, but also based on the decision of whether we want to make new choice, new decision, new step forward every day. Are you bored when do you have a friend that every time when they meet you they have nothing new to talk about, always talk about last time? Huh? Have or not? Huh? I'm sure I'm one of them. Correct? We'll call a favorite called Mr. Teng Pai. Huh? Mr. Teng Pai. Oh, last time. Ku Pai, Teng Pai, Ku Cha. Last time. Okay. Have? Do you feel bored with this person? Hello? Yeah. All they know how to talk is last time. Lebih sian meh. How are you going to live your life to the future? It's also very different on whether you want to live your life last time. Last time when people work, they have to be physically there to work. Correct? Hello? Yes. Maybe if you sell something or do work, boss must see you there to work. Correct? Now, do people still 100% expect that? No. You don't have to be here, but your work is done. Okay. Can work from home, work overseas, work this, work that, but you not necessarily mean sit there. Right? You can work with your mobile, work through your computer, your spirit tablet, you know. The more modern you are, the more spirit tablets you have. They xin zhu bai. Some are bigger, some are smaller. What's the latest one, your office? What do you call it? The latest tombstone, what do you call? Huh? iPad Air. No. The other one that you are working, Surface what? Pro 3. That's your latest tombstone. Why? Bodhidharma meditated with such natural ease that the face of the cave had his look. We also meditate with such intensity in front of this spirit tablet that sometimes go off, sometimes go on. It has our energy in it. Do you believe me? Do you believe me? Huh? You put maybe 5% same iPad on the table, Okay? Cover it with cloth. The moment I flip open, do you know which is your phone? Huh? Do you know? Will you know? Almost naturally, you know. Almost. Because you probably had some marking here and there, had some sticker, had some different... Okay. But remove all of this. Can you recognize? If all the phone came from the factory and opened up, can you recognize? You cannot recognize. So it's the same as us. If we remove, how do we reach out to each other to practice the Dharma? It's not so much to talk about the past, not so much to this and that, but to remove the facade of each other. Go back to the original source. That we are all human beings. We all need to eat. We all need to drink. So the best way to connect is eating and drinking. And we all need to exercise. So the best thing to do is to exercise, to eat and to drink. Right? Do you not need to eat? Do you need to eat? If I ask, do you not need to eat? Yeah. What kind of question is that? Okay? So, stop complaining about last time. Stop justifying about why this and that. And stop blaming each other. This is number one. And number next thing is, because today I'm talking about the readjustments of you. Stop thinking of that you come temple, you are here to get all your wishes come true. Right? If you want all your wishes to come true, go to church. Go to a charismatic church. Why? Because if you go to church in Singapore, right, what do they give you? What do they tell you? They say, my brother goes to church. My nephews and niece go to church. They have a sticker somewhere that says, proclaim God's favor. Okay? To me, I always ask myself, really, I'm so blessed that Buddha talked about equanimity. Imagine parents favor some children against some siblings. Do you feel your parent love your brother or your sister more than you? Huh? Yes, sir. Okay. That means if you still feel like that, you are putting lah. That's last time. Your parents dead already. Okay. Maybe your brothers and sisters felt your parents love you more than them. Okay? So, all these are the things, you know, that I feel favoritism is no necessity. If you go to church in Singapore, they talk a lot about success. But if you come to temple in Singapore, they talk about facing your mind. We talk about success. Maybe somebody asked me to do, oh, maybe Ramachandra, you should do like, telling people, come and pray to Tara. She will bestow special blessings upon you. She will give you a special this, special that. And I was thinking about this. This is not me. This is not me. The purpose of why we are practicing, cultivating particular deity or tantric practice is because we need to go to the fundamental of the death process. We need to die first. What is death? The death of your identity. Right? Yeah. The death of identity. The death of identity that maybe was, where's the croissant girl? She was sitting, oh, croissant girl, okay. There's a croissant girl there, okay? And there's a croissant man there, yeah. And there are the char kway teow boys and the mee siam girls, okay? We need the depth of the identity of who we are, what we are, and this and that. When it comes to death that you meditate on every day, that we are supposed to meditate on death every day, you need to be aware of the feeling when we say, now let's feel that we are going to die, and then we are entering this clear light. A beginner level, whatever your, some people have fear, some people feel they're okay, some people feel happy. For a beginner level, they will feel fear. Oh, I'm gonna die, and this and that. For a middling level, they will feel, oh, it's okay. There is some acceptance. For a spiritual cultivator, a higher, deeper level, they will feel happy when they die. Because they have they have not wasted a day of their life. So, how we are going to be every day is not to rely upon anybody's favor, not human, not God, but our own sincere effort to understand ourselves, our past, our growing up stage, everything. And then, how it is able to, and how we are able to use that to reflect to, reflect upon ourselves to become a deeper person. How can you run with a 20 kilo fuel pack, with a bag filled with 2 sacks of rice, with 20 kilos? You cannot run far. You can run for a while, not far. We really need to let go of the past. And let go, it means to put it down. Say, oh, okay, I understood this and that, and then now I let go and I change. If you don't change, you'll never have a different result. If you don't change. Some of us have got very difficult childhood, very difficult family. Till now, family is still difficult. Everything. Livelihood may have turned good. But, you know, some people now they are financially rich, but spiritually poor, because they believe that they have been poor, and so even though they are rich, they still eat very, very simple, and they don't know how to, they still have the kind of a poor mentality. That's why, you know, this mentality, poor mentality, causes maybe some poor people to strike it rich, they become multimillionaires, and after that they become poor again. They spend and spend and spend and spend and buy and buy and buy. After that, they don't know how to manage the money and they become poor again. There are many people like that, you know? Many people like that. To be wealthy means to be able to become like a bowl, a cup, a container that is not leaky. You must dare to accept that I was born and conditioned in a leaky cup. I'm willing to throw that away, and I'm willing to buy a good quality cup now. Maybe not a porcelain one, not a plastic one, but a stainless steel one. Maybe dense, but will not break so, may dent, but not break so easily. That's why there are some people who find jobs and jobs. They can work well for a while. After that, they are not happy. They resign and they resign and they work and they change and they resign and they work and they change and they resign. After a while, they always face the same problem. It is not other people's problem. It is our problem. And then they always say that, oh, it is Buddhist or any other religion people, religious people will say that pray for success, pray for this, pray for that. If you know me, I pray for nothing. I only pray for you to be happy. To be, that you awake. This is very, I feel, more important. Your inner happiness, your inner awakefulness. You know, have you ever had some friends who you know they are in a bad relationship, they are doing everything wrong, but no matter what you say, they won't listen? Do you have? Have? You don't have. Okay, some have, some don't have. But after some time, suddenly, somehow, somewhere, some way, they suddenly wake up and realize what you said was true. And that person had that awakening, like struck by lightning, had that awakening. Will you feel happier for that person? Hello? Will you feel happy for if your friend suddenly can understand and awaken to the truth? Okay? So this is what I'm talking about. Giving them money because they want to borrow money from you, giving them material aid, giving them this, giving them that. All good, great, but not permanent. Give them the skill to see clearly. Give them the skill to be able to realize. And then when they realize, they will know how to readjust their expectations. If you continue to say, oh, I want this, I want that, all their life they're chasing after illusion. I want to find at the end of the rainbow, there's really a pot of gold. How many of you walked through the end of a rainbow before? Have you? I have. I'm not joking. I have. 3 times in my life. There was the rainbow there shining down. I saw it. One time I drove through it. One time, 2 times I walked through it. And immediately I was just saying, 2 times Sangula was with me. I told Sangula, say, where's that pot of gold? And they say, where's that pot of gold? One time I was very young in Nepal with my guru. And then we walked on the rail. I was telling my guru, says, that I said, the Inji people say, if there's this end of the rainbow, beginning of the rainbow, there is a pot of gold. Yeah. My guru say, yeah, the illusion is their dream, the illusion is their gold. Okay? So when I say I want you to change, I want you to change about the expectation of you with coming to the temple and you with each other. Because everybody who comes to a temple got problem, right? Hello? Everybody who come to temple means they got problem, right? No. Some people used to have problem, but then they grew out of it. Some of you look and feel totally very different from the first time you came. I give you one very good example. I will mention names. Okay? Li Ying. Yeah. She went through a very difficult time of her life. Yeah. And then she looked totally different. She looked like a man. She looked like a man and was very strong and very fit. And then one day she came and we talked, and then she told me everything about, and then she cried. Then I gave her advice and I said, it's already over. And she evolved. And I was so happy, and she evolved. She evolved. She met the people who created that difficult situation. And I also met that person who created, because that time I pray, oh, that difficult people or something, I pray for them. So really, one day in the aeroplane or somewhere, I met that person she was talking about. So she, me, and the other person was there. And then she was telling, oh, this is the person I was telling you about. Immediately, I could realize, oh. Yeah. Huh? It's here. Visak day, yeah? Oh, yeah. You see? That person who seemingly caused her great harm, and she was very near. But, and she couldn't get on with her life. But then, after the advice and this and that, she could face it. And then I was like, this most wonderful. You know, when faced with the person who gave you the greatest suffering later on and still can be friend and still can introduce to guru, and this is the person that, that actually I'm very happy. I'm very happy because you moved on. That means that heavy rock already rolled off. Some people last time used to sell food, and then after that, you know, there are many, many people in the past sell food, I realize, over here. Parents sell food, and so always, you know, got disturbed by secret society, got this and that, or whatever. Then life was very tough, and yes, I know, some selling satay, some selling this, some selling that, all kind of food. But then now life changed. But did your mind change? Now, last time you don't even have enough food to survive. Now you got house, got car, got wife, got husband, got children, got this. But did you evolve from there? Or do you still have that mentality that must stand there, must do, equates to working? Okay. So we need to readjust our internal mindset. With regards to our childhood, with regards to each other. So sometimes when you see people have difficulty, tell them that you understand and that you can give support, provided they are willing. But sometimes you yourself also need support. Don't think that, oh, I don't need support. Some of you may feel that, oh, I practice until very good already. I can see Buddha, can see this, can see that. My guru tell me what, no? Dream Momo, no Momo. See, dream Buddha, no Buddha. If you really see the Buddha, then that Buddha is in that, suppose your, that Buddha must be your Buddha nature that has become you. You know, every time in the past, last time, you know, people who are from all over the world, Malaysia, Singapore, Taiwan, they used to ask Geshe Lama Kuncho. And now I see his reincarnation giving teaching. You saw Facebook? Yeah, his reincarnation giving teaching, 12 years old. Then make me think about this inside is that old man. Yeah. And so, you know, many people ask my guru, I saw Avalokiteshvara, I saw Tara, I saw this and that, and they came and gave me this. And my guru just very straight, very direct. When people say good dreams, and if people say bad dream, he just say, dream Momo, no Momo. Momo means you call Xiao Long Bao. Yeah. You know Xiao Long Bao? Huh? Hello? Oh, yeah. Okay. Dream Momo, no Momo. And then some people say, that, oh, I saw this, that, this, and then my guru say, oh, really? Very good. What Dharma advice did the deity give you? Ask me to buy 4D. Yeah. You see, it's things like this is supposed to call the needle that bursts your bubble. Right? Some people are also pretty difficult. They feel that if they are gay or lesbian, then, or some people are transsexual, some people are, what do you call? One more? I don't know. I'm not sure this one. Some changed sex, some didn't change sex. Whatever. Some people, then that become a very big part of their life. And I want to tell you, people's sexuality, they feel their sexuality is a very big thing in their life. And I want to tell you something about it. It is true because you were created through your parents' sex. You were created from there, right? So because you were created from there, that will affect you. But then, you don't spend 24 hours or even 8 hours a day having sex, isn't it? So sometimes, I feel every time when people start to talk about this, put them at ease. It's okay, whatever your sexual orientation may be, you are still a human being. That means it's the same thing that I'm talking about. Release the idea that you are of this race, of that race, of this sexuality, of that sexuality, of this belief. Some people tell me, say, I'm very, very high sex drive. I don't know what to do about it. They get very angry. I'm a Buddhist. I'm not supposed to be like this. And blah, 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 blah. Then I just look at them and let them rant. When they finish talking, then I say, you come ask me for advice, or you come and want me to listen to you talk? Okay? Whoever you may be, whatever you may be, whatever your sexuality, whether you're gay, you're straight, you're lesbian, you're bi, you are transsexual, you are transvestite, you are, I don't know what else, what other labels people may give you, you are special. Why are you special? How many billion people now? 7 billion people, not one of them same as you. You are special only because nobody else is the same as you. But you will only be truly special if what you do can be of benefit for all these other people. If cannot benefit all 7 billion, few hundred also good. Wa? Even if it's, the text says, even if it's for one sentient being, for one being, you can give the advice and you give the support and you give the experience, share the experience, and that person transform. That's the very, very special. Right? For some of you girls here who told me that you were raped before, it's over. Right? It's over. Whether you were, some of you who were raped, or some of the men here also that says that you were raped, you were molested, you were this or you that, it's over. Why do you, if you realize all these things that I'm talking about, it's the same as you have that one friend that always talk to you and nothing new to say, always talk about last time. You are your dead friend. Hello? You feel funny, is it? Now I talk about this kind of thing. Huh? Feel funny. Feel, well, I'm teaching and everybody must be thinking about something. The look on everybody's face goes like this. This everybody, almost everybody's face go like this. They go, hello. Hello. I need to buy what do you call that? You wear something here and you have this camera. What do you call that? Huh? GoPro. Okay, I need to buy one. So teaching time, I need to wear this GoPro here. This is called the crown of all encompassing space. What are you wearing? This can you cannot see that crown? And I've got a special third eye. Wherever I go, you know. After that, when I go back and then now I go and look at all the people's funny faces, those falling asleep, drooling, find gold on the ground. Find gold on the ground. Yeah. Everybody goes, this kind of look, right? So that after that I can post on social media, Instagram, Twitter, fun faces. Or I can use that to blackmail you. Do volunteer work or else. So why do I ask you to do volunteer work? Why do I create such things? It's because in your ordinary life, you would never have done anything like that. Never. You would just be a very ordinary person, go to work, go home, eat and sleep. Wake up, wash up, go to work, eat, work, finish work, overtime, go home, sleep. Every day is like this. Right? Hello? Yeah. That's why I have to force you. Thursday, Friday nights for teaching, best. Thursday, Friday night, your friends will never come for teaching because it's a drinking night. It's a party night, right? TGIF, thank God it's Friday. And then they say, go Friday, go chiong, right? Go happy, right? And then a friend asks you go out, they say, cannot, I go teaching. You, something wrong, you. Huh? The something wrong one say you something wrong. You understand? Yeah. People say you something wrong here. Something wrong say who? Disturb them a bit. Have some fun. Okay? This is very important. That's why if you say, you know, sometime when people come for Dharma teaching and after some while they don't want to come back, it's because they also having problem inside. And when those people who have problem, they will see that everybody else have the same problem. An angry person will see anger in everybody else. Correct? That's why angry person will always end up fighting with other people. Because the other person who also got anger problem will also come temple trying to find peace. You also got anger problem, try to come temple and try to find peace. Come to temple, Buddha is having the peace. Buddha look at both of you fighting, he is still have his peace. And it's funny lah, never mind. Just meditate and look. Be at ease. They whack, they beat each other up, they pain only one. Call police law later. When that fat llama still don't come out and see them. Huh? Right? So you must understand. You must understand this. Okay? You who have the problem, other people have problem too. Okay? So, I feel church is very successful because they tell people about what they can achieve and what they can this, what they can that, because that is telling them that to forget your problem, forget about your old problem, give them to God, and then they do to achieve. They want to do what they want to achieve. But to me, that is good, but not deep enough. Maybe my ideology of being Buddhist, what I really want you to achieve is you can drop your old bags. imagine you go, tertiary education, right? But you still need to take your books all the way from primary one. Yeah, in university. Do you understand what I'm saying? A lot of you are doing this to yourself. You are doing this to yourself. You don't let go of your past. You are doing this to yourself. From kindergarten, your toys, your everything. Everywhere you go, you're carrying and carrying and carrying. Primary one books, primary two books, primary three books. The more education, you just look at the clutter you have in your house. Oh, from last time on, then this one, last time story, last time, last time, last time. There's nothing in your house. That's why I say, the moment I go to your house, I know everything about you. Is there anything futuristic in your house? Or is there everything that is laid back? Or some people's house is like a rag and bone man house. Many people's house like rag and bone man house. Is your house over cluttered? Or your house only one color, everything white? Want to be clean and everything. Those people who want everything white, everything clean, everything spotless, they have a lot of rubbish inside. They have a lot of 很复杂, 叫什么? Very complex heart, very complex mind. That's why they everything need white. Yeah? So, really, we want to practice Dharma? You really want to be a better person? Stop. Aren't you tired? You ask yourself, are you tired? If you're tired, start to rest, let go of the past. If you're tired of doing, educate the other people to help themselves. Stop doing everything for everyone. Stop doing everything for everyone. Let people, you know, slip and fall. Let people knock their head. Let people get some kind of injury. You know, at least they got some excitement in their lives, isn't it? Let people fall in love. And let people feel sad and everything. It's okay, never mind. Let them go through it. Only the stupid fall in love. The wise rise in love. Right? They say, before married, everything is a wonder. Everything that happens is a wonder. After marriage, you wonder what happened. I heard this from Kuma. Yeah. So I thought it was very funny. Yeah. Everything is a wonder. Just now also I finally got my TV set fixed. So I didn't get the chance to watch TV for some time. So my eyes was glued to the TV in the evening after it got repaired. And that repaired man came and scolded me. You pressed the wrong button, that's why not working lah. He thought I was stupid. So I was thinking, I must say something. I want to say something. Say, uncle, I press already lah. I press all three button lah, uncle. Okay. Then after that, he was still very adamant that it was my mistake. Then he still put back and say, oh yeah, so sure. Oh, then after that he say, oh, must be because lightning lah. Now blame lightning that. Okay. So. So in press and then it was an old Hong Kong program, some old movie about people really falling in love. I was just looking at it, I was just laughing, I was just giggling my head off. Right? The illusion of falling in love. Right? Or the awakening of, you know, sentient beings have small love. That's why they fall down, fall in love. Buddhas and Bodhisattvas have great love, big love. So that's why they rise. Once they become parents, the small love changed to become big love. They no longer love their spouse as special anymore. Children more important. Everything else, work more important, food more important, what pay bill more important, everything else. But forget about the wife lah. Forget about the husband, don't care. So that's why fall down and then they will stand up, they say, oh. What? Then they feel very happy when the children fall in love and get married. Very good. And they call this the circle of life or the cycle of life. Never mind, it's okay. Everybody got their own karma. You want to get married? Get married. Okay? Sooner or later, we'll separate. You're either separate by divorce, separate by everything, or separate by death. One. Correct? Yeah. You see, many things is a matter of fact. But how you say it, how I say it maybe will affect people very adversely. Or how I say it can maybe treat it as a, oh yeah, awakening. Okay? So the matter is, why do I still want to say it? Right? Some people say, oh, you're the Rinpoche, you can say whatever you want to say. It's not true. But why do I say the things that I say? Now I want to tell you. One of the main reasons are, I need you to change the way you are working with your mind, with your life, or with your manifestation. Some people say, oh, I love you, what? I love one. But they don't show properly, you know. They just do their thing. When they meet you, then they love you. Don't meet you, you're out of sight, out of mind. Why do I say certain things like that? It's because there's something not too beneficial manifestation that you have. See, now I'm very careful with the word. Huh? I don't want to say it's not too right about the way you behave. Versus, there's not too very beneficial manifestation that you have. I have to be skillful. Correct? Hello? Correct or not? Huh? You want me to be blunt or you want me to be sharp? Huh? Sharp, huh? Really? Cannot, nah. Right? A cane, I whack you with a cane, one stroke of the cane is less painful than a slice of a razor. So how can I be too sharp? Correct? Yeah. Somebody come and tell me, Rinpoche, Sifu, last time my wife not like that one eh. That I tell you now. Actually, last time your wife all the while like that one eh. That time your third eye not open. Ah, your third eye not open. You understand? Right? So, reality is, if you want to have a a spouse or everything, you get married because you fall in love and you just want this and that, it won't last. But if you get married because of supporting each other, companionship, of support, or love, and trust, and faith, and everything, it will last. But some people have too much of that idea. First time failure, whole life failure. First time failure, whole life failure. Why do I say that? Because they don't dare to open their hearts again. So we go back to the root of the problem. What is in that heart? Open that heart is maybe a can of worms. It's the same reason why people go temple. I'm Buddha. People don't like to pray to Buddha or Kuan Yin because it's the mother, right? Or everything I can tell the Holy Mother. Holy Mother, Kuan Yin Buddha. Oh, I got this problem, got that problem. Or is you are forcing your expectation to Kuan Yin, to Avalokiteshvara, to Chenrezig, correct or not? So when you open up and then you have all your expectations of love for that person dumb you, that person die, that person this, that person that, who get hurt? Who gets hurt in the end? Who got hurt? Huh? Self? In reality, this is a human being problem. Yourself is not hurt. Your expectations got hurt. If yourself is hurt, you cannot even sleep. Right? It is your expectations, your demands, your what, everything got so badly hurt. Got injured, got hurt. In the Heart Sutra, okay, which was taught by Buddha for humans. There's no eye, no ear, no mouth, no tongue, no body, no mind, no mind dhatu. Okay? If this was taught to stone, will a stone have eyes, nose, ear, mouth, body, mind, feeling, this aggregates? No. So this was specifically, if this was taught to animals, does the animal have this? Eyes, nose, ear, mouth, body, mind, have? Have? Now, can the animal understand this? Hello? Can animal understand? No. Animal have a very, very strong sense of self and identity. What kind or that's why the animal goes, oh, they realize some animals like to look at themselves in a mirror. And some animals have a very strong smell. That is their identity, their mark. That's why dogs go around peeing everywhere to do their marking. Right? But you apply, read this Heart Sutra to the animal. Can the animal understand anything? No, cannot. So we read this for a human mind. Can the human mind understand it? No, human mind get very confused by it. How can there be no mind, no eye, no ear, no nose, no mouth, no body, no mind, no everything, no, then what Buddha, then everything, then Buddha say good, good, very good. Huh? This is so, this is the way, this is such. Then what? What? Pray Buddha for what? Everything empty, what? Everything nothing, what? Correct? So because human have the idea, it's either have or don't have. Don't have middle. Have means have, don't have means don't have. Right? Hello? Yeah. So that's why Buddha say, human can awaken to that slowly. The skill of the teacher and the wisdom of the disciple. Okay? Chinese, this character, 智慧的慧, on top the 草字头, right? On top means grass. The center is hand, bottom is heart. You break it up means to have a clear heart, you need to use the hand to pick the broom and clean the heart. This is the word wisdom. Do you know? Can you see? On top, if you write the word wisdom, there's grass, there's a hand, looks like a hand, right? And there's a heart, right? Yeah. So how do you have wisdom? You must use the broom to clean up your heart so you can see not with your eyes but with your heart. So this is something that is very important in Buddhism. Success, worldly success, all that is based on your karma, your worldly karma, your worldly cleverness, your intelligence. An extremely rich, shrewd businessman, wealthy business person and everything may be shrewd, may be cunning, but may not be wise. Correct? May be shrewd, may be cunning to make a lot of money, to do very well, but may not be wise. So in Buddhism, the main thing is our heart, our mind. We are focusing on the sore spot. Our heart, our mind is always, you know, the sore spot. When you are young, before 30, you wouldn't have much of a sore spot. Or before 20, you wouldn't have much of a sore spot. But that is the best time to learn Buddhism. Because you can have a lot of intellectual comments on it. But write them down. As life goes by and you fall down and get up and get kicked and get bumped, then look through what you wrote in the last time and then laugh. Like, give you a very good example, okay? If I ask you to eat health supplement before 50, you say, no need, can eat from food and everything. By the time we talk to people who are over 50, they say, yeah, it's true. You cannot get enough of this from this food that you eat. Why? Because we are very habitual. We only want to eat what we want to eat. Correct? Not eat what we are supposed to eat. So how can our diet be balanced? That's why we get all kinds of sickness. By the time somebody hits over 50 or 60, those people will be very interested because they got money, they got everything, but now they need to be alive. They want to be alive. That's why when you're young, you hear the word doctor, inauspicious person. All doctors are polluted. They always mix around with sick and dying. But when you're old, you say, oh, doctor. Oh, yeah, you're very respectable, doctor. This is not because the fault of doctor, but it's because of experience of person. Similarly, supplements are like Buddha Dharma. Okay? Supplements are like Buddha Dharma. Those people, many people tell me, oh, Lama, Rinpoche, Sifu, I wish I had met Dharma earlier. I told him, I say, even if you met Dharma earlier, without the right condition, maybe you would not even have benefited from it. Right, there are people who are working with Dharma day in and out, but they don't benefit from it because there's nothing very much to it. Okay, so one needs to really work within oneself for Dharma. The older you get, the deeper the teachings, Buddha's teaching, seem to make sense. Okay? That's why meditation is very good for people over 40 or 50 years old. The young one, ask them to meditate. Why? Because the rest of the time went clubbing, dancing, this and that. Once you're over 40 or 50, meditate. Oh, relaxing, good. Very calming, very nice, very this, very that. And then after that, they come and tell me, meditation, very good, very this, very that. I said, your meditation is all wrong. Why? It's good. It benefited me. I'm happy, you know. My mind clear, you know. I can see Buddha, you know. Huh? I can see the bright light, you know. I meditate, no. Can you see? That's why all it takes is Buddha, meditation not for you. You're not meditating correctly. Why? Very simple. Because they are meditating the way that they want. Whatever they could not have reached or have the success in the earlier part of their life, they feel that spirituality is the way to get back at everyone. So, one way is this. Some people say to me, if they don't do well as a lay person, they will do very well as an ordained person. Some people who don't do very well as an ordained person will do very well as a lay person. This you have to go observe yourself. Whether it is true or not, you observe yourself. Okay. Many people actually can already become monks and nuns, but just because they don't know or don't want or still at the cross, they believe they're at a crossroad and they don't dare to take the step out or this and that or whatever. I'm not interested. Okay? I just need you to be see within and without clearly. See and have beneficial manifestation of your outer appearance. Do you understand what I'm saying? Beneficial manifestation of your outer appearance. Very important. Yeah. Okay. My advice, don't live in your past anymore. Be futuristic. Yeah. And don't live in your problems. They are only situations that are existing because of now. Given time, given conditions, given this and that, things will change. They will evolve. This is also something that is very important. Right? So, it's like baking bread. Putting yeast and water and sugar and flour and mixing it up. Give it time. Give it this, give it that. It will evolve. It will become... Bake it and it becomes bread. Don't bake it and it will become rotten water very soon. Okay? Bake it and don't eat it, also it will become stale bread and rotten bread. Bake it and eat it while it's fresh, it will also become shit. Right? So, choose what to do for the benefit for others, not for yourself. This is very important, okay? Remember, don't do everything for everyone. Teach them to do for themselves is the best thing you can do for everyone. Teach them so that they know what they should do, what they can do, how they can do, how they can be independent, how they can think, how they can feel, how they can react, how they can something, many things. This is more important than just giving them money, giving them 4D number, like that. Okay? Yeah. That's it for today. You're a bit danced out already. Because as I start talking, you have a recollection of your... You're having recollections of your life already. You all start to have that look. You all have that yam look. You know yam? And sweet potato, the yams? You have that yam look. Yam dog look. Oh. Okay. Okay, we offer a mandala, which is actually the offering of our own inner space. Before we offer the inner space, we need to create the inner space for our own heart. Om Mahong. This ground anointed with perfume, bestrewn with flowers, with Mount Meru in the middle. Filled with jewels, and a palace of the gods in the middle, right on the top, with the sun and the moon, the precious parasol and a victory banner, the four great lands and the eight subcontinents and the lakes of eight lakes of fresh waters, beautiful vast grasslands with wildflowers, all that is natural. Clear, fresh space and air, and the clear skies, and the cool breeze. The eight auspicious signs, and the eight medicinal substances, and the eight royal and secondary royal signs. This and all things that we love and enjoy offer in a visualization. A Guru, Buddha, Dhamma and Sangha. May all sentient beings be able to enjoy such pure land. Idam Guru Ratna Mandalogon Iyadaya. So may the precious body mind not yet born arise and grow. May that bond have no decline but increase forevermore. Okay, so that's it for tonight. Please think about what you heard. Go and reflect and drop your past, change your manifestation, your outer manifestation. Yeah. Rearrange your expectations. Yeah. And choose to be happy. You have a choice. Choose to be happy. If other people make you not happy, then you have to explain why you are not happy. and and you have to listen to the other person, why that person make you not happy. If not, there's a very strong you and I. So very important, reflect upon it. And if what other person say make more sense, be brave to readjust your life, your mind and your life. Yeah. That's very important. Okay? Yeah. If you don't remember, if you don't do anything, if you don't do anything and you do everything the same way, don't expect anything to change in your life. Don't expect it. Everything will carry on the same way, the same damn bloody way, some of you say, that it has been. Okay? So you have to make that change. You have to do it. Nobody else can do it for you. Going to different places, different teachers, different everywhere, hearing different styles and different this, different that, but not even, it's like going to see different doctor but not eating any medicine. Nobody can help you. Nobody can let you evolve. Okay? Good night.